Dear Gilad, Ehud and Eldad, we want you to know that we are standing here and we are with you. I wish you were all with us. Students from all over the world living in freedom have helped organize a solidarity manifestation especially for you. The students who have helped organize this important event here in Amsterdam are members of Bnei Akiva, Habonim Dror, the Jewish Agency and CEO, and especially Roberta, Nadav and Elizabeth. Rabbi David Lilenthal, Ruben Fis, Chaverot v'Chaverim Shalom. Today, here in Amsterdam, the capital of the Netherlands, as well as in many, many cities around the globe, almost 100 cities, we all raised our voices loudly and clearly for a just and simple humanitarian cause. Today is marked by a worldwide rally of solidarity for our abducted and missing Israeli soldier, and is meant to send a clear message to Tehran and Damascus, a message based on one of the most profound principles of Jewish tradition and international humanitarian law. Under humanitarian law, we are obliged to guarantee the lives of enemy soldiers who were captured and to report their conditions. And so we do, with every and each prisoner of the other side. Our enemies are obliged to do the same actions, but they refuse to do it. Under Jewish tradition, we are obliged to our brothers and sisters who have been captured by our enemies not to rest a day, nor spare any effort to discover what has happened to them and to demand their safe return until they are all back home. Today, based upon these noble moral principles that are shared instinctively by the vast majority of mankind, but again, definitely not by some of our neighbors, the students of the free world and all of us are calling, release a sign of life of our Israeli soldiers. There are less than 10. Stop the torture of the families. Behave like civilized human beings. Give reliable evidence that our brothers are still with us and that they are being treated humanly. If they are not alive, say the truth. Enough with the human suffering you are causing our soldiers and their families. Tragically, the story of Gilad, Ehud and Eldad is not the only one. We are obliged to bring all our missing soldiers back home. The tragic story began 25 years ago, actually even earlier. The early part is the tragedy of three soldiers who didn't return from the battle near the village of Sultan Yaakob in Lebanon in June 1982. Ever since that day, we are all waiting to know what has happened to the three brother soldiers, Zecharia Baumel, Zvi Feldman, and Yehuda Katz. Their history are a shivering reflection of the history of the Jewish people in our days. Take, for example, Zecharia Baumel. Zecharia was born in Brooklyn, New York, already 47 years ago, but his inner compass carried him to Israel, to his own people. Zecharia's last message to his worried parents concluded with a brief note of assurance. Don't worry. Everything is okay. But it looks I won't be home for a while. Over the last 2 decades, his family has traveled the world following every clue and knocking on every door. But those who know the answer keep inhumanly silent. His tank team member, Zvi Feldman, was born already 51 years ago in Tel Aviv, Israel. His father, Avraham, came to Israel from Europe after having lost his entire family in the Holocaust. Zvi, the oldest of 4 children, is named after his grandfather who was murdered by the Nazis. His birth has signaled the beginning of a new future in a new land for a family that had all but perished in Eastern Europe. Together with them, the traces of Yehuda Katz were lost as well. Yehuda Katz was born 47 years ago in Ramat Gan, Israel. Both his parents, Yosef and Sarah, are Holocaust survivors. His dream was to become one day a leading Judaic scholar or rabbinic figure, a dream that seems now further away than ever since that battle of June 1982. Let us hope that the words of his father called back in 1994, "Yehuda, Yehuda, come home quickly," will be answered soon. For surely someone, somewhere, must know where they are and what has happened to them, and that person should stand up and declare it out of a moral decree, and by so doing, that person will bring an end to the unbearable suffering of our soldiers and their families. Ladies and gentlemen, throughout the almost 6 years of Israel's existence, there is perhaps no other name that has become so synonymous with the Israeli missing in actions, such as Air Force Lieutenant Colonel Ron Arad. Ron Arad was born almost 50 years ago in Israel. He was an Air Force navigator in an F-4 Phantom jet. Almost exactly 21 years ago, on October 16, 1986, he was captured by a member of the Amal Shia militia in Lebanon after bailing out of his crippled warplane over the Lebanese city of Sidon. In one of the few letters he could deliver to his wife 20 years ago, on the eve of Rosh Hashanah, he made a desperate call for his release. "Please do your best to get me out of here. Lebanon is not a place to be, and I really want to see you all. Yom Kippur is approaching, and I will be praying together with you. Let's hope that he will help the leaders to make the right choices. But you, we, can also help. Let us join Ron Arad's hope from his unknown place of captivity. Let us all hope that he will soften the stony hearts of his captors." Guy Hever is yet another Israeli soldier who was disappeared. It happened near the border of Israel with Syria. Guy was born in Tel Aviv 30 years ago. 10 years ago, his parents, Srina and Eitan, spent the day with him before he returned to his unit in the Golan Heights. The next day, Guy left his base to return home, carrying only his weapon and his keys. Later that same day, he was reportedly seen standing just 1 kilometer away from the border with Syria.